When I first took on the women's department, my heart was not completely in it. And I had many complaints about the work that was needed to be done, and I was whining about the time I had to put in. Sometimes when you take on different things, you don't realize that that's your time you need to put in.
Amen.
You actually need to hear from God first, especially when you serve people. You're the leader of something.
That's right.
You need to be an example.
That's right.
In order for you to be the example, I needed to put time in with God. I needed to sit down and read.
Right.
I needed to read God's word. I needed to sit down and meditate and hear from Him. So it took away me time.
Right.
That I was not expecting to have to give up. But I thank God for those, for these times of learning, reading His Word, understanding His Word. Because not only did I have to read it, but I had to understand. So I had to study Bibles and break down things so that I can understand it for myself. Because not only was I coming to a women's meeting, it's not, I never wanted the women's department to just be a meeting. I wanted it to be a meeting as far as my business and everything else, but in the end, I always wanted something to encourage, just to get you through the next 30 days of our, until our next meeting. So I started to ask God for different ways. I had never participated in the women's department before, so I had no clue. Out of my own ignorance, I only thought it was for old ladies.
All right, that's
and
okay.
So I never attended. I never participated. I never felt that I was a woman because I was still young. So I came up with some excuses to God of why I couldn't do the work that He needed me to do. I was too young. I really didn't want to be over the women's department, but I'm going to do it because I said I was going to do it, and I try to be a person of my word. With all the complaining and the work that needed to be done and the whining about the time that I had to put in, I felt that I was too young to be over the women's department and I wanted to do something else. Don't ever tell God when He tells you to do something, you want to do something else. Because then at that point, you now open yourself up to be used in ways that you would have never imagined. When I said I wanted to do something else, God then reminded me of my promise I had made to Him last year, that I would serve Him no matter what.
Amen.
No matter what the looks were, no matter what was said about me, whatever, it didn't matter. Whatever my friends thought, it didn't matter. I was going to serve and only serve God, no matter what man said. I'm not worried about what was going to come back on me because I knew that God had told me to do it.
Yes.
So I went down on my face. This was my my first time I had to go back and ask God after I took on the women's department to forgive me. God forgive me. Because I'm complaining and I made promises. I had intentions to keep, but after I started to realize I had no intentions to keep, I had to go back and ask God to forgive me. Then I told God, I said, you know what, God, okay. I give myself away. Taking on the women's department, it would satisfy my word that I told God, and that it would hold. I would hold a couple of meetings, and that would be done until the end of the year. But at my first meeting, me listening to God, put out some papers on the tables, and I said, "You can write anything on these papers. You can write a prayer request. Mm-hmm. You can write suggestions that needed to be done that you would like to see in the women's department." Well, there was a couple of them that took me serious on a prayer request. I said, it's my time, again, that I have to put in. So I did. I went before God with the prayer request that was given to me. And for 2 months, I never responded to the responses that God gave me, because I didn't like the answer that God gave me to respond back to some of them. I didn't think they were fair. So I complained to God again. I said, God, why? Why do I gotta give those answers? Why do I have to give that answer? That you're not gonna like that answer. And again, me, self, was worried about how they were gonna think, how they were gonna feel about me.
All right, now.
Even though God gave me the scripture that says to serve him with my wholehearted devotion, mm-hmm. with a willing mind, I still got nervous about doing what God had told me to do. And I didn't want to go and tell the responses to them. But I did eventually. I went back and they were very receptive of what God had told me to do. And I said, God, that was easy. I should have did that the first 2 months you told me to do it. They were understanding. They received it. And even some of them were even like, oh, I knew there was going to come back. I knew there was going to come back for my answer. But I said, you know, God, I thank you for using me.
Yeah.
And that way, I thank you for allowing me to be willing.
Yeah.
But self slip in again. I let self slip in and worry me again. So I started to complain. Again, I thank God for my husband because he's my complainer to person. I went home and started complaining again. And I said, okay, I'm complaining. And God brought back to my remembrance again. Your promise you made to me will serve me no matter what.
Amen.
I said, all right, God. He said, when he gave me back my own words, he said, you gave yourself away. Remember that? Remember you gave yourself for me to use you?
Wow.
And you said you were willing. Remember, you said you were willing? What happened? Time number two, I gotta go back to my face and say, God, forgive me. I will serve you no matter what. Then I came back and I said, okay, God, and I got up and I said, yes. Oh yes. Oh yes. Yes. Oh yes. Yeah, yes. Yeah, yes. He said, okay. You give yourself away. Okay, just you said yes.
Yes.
Be available.
Yes, Lord.
Word number two is available. I said, God, I got this. I can be available. That's not a problem now. I'm a master at this. I can be available. I can give you my wholehearted devotion. God started to give me things to share with the women's department every month to encourage them and uplift them and also encourage myself. He gave me things that were little things. I think we get bubbles at one time. When you blow your bubbles to God, and your pops just know God's got it. We had Christmas in July where you had to go to your sacred place with God and pray. And enjoy God. Yes. Write him your story, write him your love letter, your song, whatever it was. We had team building, you had to cheer on your team. Get to know who those who are on your team within your church and within the women's department. Get to know each other. Write things down on a piece of paper and pass to someone you don't even know. Encourage somebody. Yeah. Encourage somebody else other than yourself. I said, God, I thank you for these things. I thank you for these things. I said, but, you know, self trips in again. You start to complain again. And I said, all right, God, I'm complaining again. Every time I felt that I wasn't receiving something from God, I would complain. I saw that I would complain. I didn't want to get up in a meeting and not be prepared or embarrass myself or God or even my family. I start to complain. I saw then I started to complain because I felt that God wasn't giving me what I was supposed to get. But if I just sat down and just listened, I was getting what God told me to do. Because I serve a God of a second chance, I wasn't able to go back to God. This time, I know God's thoughts. I said, God, I know your thoughts are not my thoughts, and your ways are not my ways, but help me to accept and to do what you would have me to do. God, this time you're my desire.
Yeah. Right now. Amen. All right. Amen.